Hey, welcome back into today's video. We got another one for you about a creepy man on TikTok. It seems like TikTok is a breeding ground for just absolute terrible people. And today we're going to be talking about Paul Breach. He's around 43 to 45 years old. We don't know to be exact, and is accused of taking advantage of his fan base. There's multiple situations involving girls as young as 15 years old. It was also discovered in his mid-20s he may have gotten a 16-year-old pregnant. He seems to repeatedly slip into the DMs of these young girls that he sources from his Instagram and TikTok following. This is a creepy situation, very uncomfortable vibes. In today's episode of Exploring TikTokers, there's my tea. Somebody said they didn't like the slurp noise in my last video, so I had to do it again. Before we get started into this video, I want to raise your attention to two things. Number one, we're currently doing a charity this year to help prevent child ABUSC and help children in difficult situations. We've already risen 100. If you want to help with that, the link should be to the right on desktop, below on mobile. I'd like you to be a member of the Rep Squad, and all you got to do that is click the subscribe button underneath this video. Currently at 221,601. Let's see if we can make it to 222,000. I was told that if I told people to actually subscribe that they would. Let me know if you're a brand new sub in the comment section below, and I will heart your comment. Also, don't forget to like and comment on this video for engagement. It helps the video and the algorithm and sends it out to the people that need to see it. If you're unfamiliar, Paul is best known for singing a song about football player Jack Grealish and how he wants to breed him.
Jack Grealish, and you're like, he's my bubba. Oh, he's my boo-boo-boo-boo. Oh, he's my bubba. He's my boo-boo-boo-boo.
He also went viral again for lip-syncing the song Green Green Grass by George Ezra. This is why you'll see some people call him the Green Green Grass guy. Whew. He's currently gone viral for being an absolute creep to young girls on the internet. Paul had a TikTok account of over 800,000 followers, and most of his content was things like this.
Good morning, welcome to Tuesday. One question. Anybody giving out hugs? I think I want one.
It looks like he's live right now. This is his Instagram with over 87,000 followers. Let's see what he's saying.
My account is gone off TikTok. If it stays permanently gone, it stays permanently gone. I'll go back to a normal life eventually. I've got enough money to do what I want at the moment. Banned for what? No idea.
The amount of young females that this guy is following on Instagram, like, so we'll just scroll at random here and just we'll pick this person and see how old they are. 20. Go a little bit further and pick this person at random. They are 19 years old. As we've seen, Paul primarily follows very young women on his Instagram. He was exposed for liking pictures of bikini pictures of a young girl that was 15 when she was 16. It's pretty weird. One user discovered he followed a 19-year-old cancer survivor. He liked a picture of her in a bikini from 2 years ago when she was 17. As you can see, the types of different pictures that he is liking. He liked one of her when she was 16 years old, when she was at the prom. Another one in the bikini when she was 16. And this is how you know for a fact that he knew her age. He's liking photos of her 16th birthday party. And as you can see in this picture, she's holding up 16 balloons. Even creepier, it was discovered he liked pictures of when she was 15 years old. And I'm sure if you scrolled on further, you could find even more. Even stranger, upon investigation, it was discovered that this girl had no idea who Paul was. And his response to why he was doing this kind of... it was a weird deflection.
I will keep liking your pictures. I will also say the ladies' pictures that I've liked, like I said this morning, she suffered with cancer when she was growing up. So I will like her prom pictures because she survived to be a prom. I will like the other pictures because she was confident at posting even though she's recovered and was recovering from cancer.
This is very strange because obviously he's using cancer as a deflection excuse for why it was okay for him to like 15-year-old photos One user says, she was so brave for posting, so he had to like it because it's well-known fact that people who suffered from cancer usually don't post bikini pics. Another one saying, it's almost like he's saying he only likes people's photos who are suffering with serious illnesses, which is also weird. And pay attention to this one because it tracks later. Another user saying, all I'm hearing is he's targeting vulnerable teens. Paul makes it a habit of jumping in the DMs of his young and vulnerable viewers. And keep in mind that Paul is around 45 years old, and there's over a 20 year age difference here. So he has no business doing this. Even more concerning to me is that he goes live on Instagram, and while he's live on Instagram, he clicks his viewers and starts to DM them there while he's live. This can be seen on multiple occasions.
In my last live, I said that I'd phoned someone on Instagram, so I left to phone someone on Instagram. Just have a little conversation with the buzzer. So, because I like it, because that's what I get to do on the internet. I get to pop off for 2 seconds, speak to somebody I've never spoken to, and, like, kiss me, Kirsty. Hello, Kirsty, how are you? Sophie, hey.
It just so happens it's young and vulnerable teens that he's talking to. Here's one note to a 17-year-old.
Yeah, I'm okay. Social media can just be a disgusting place sometimes. And I'm living a stalked and harassed lifestyle at the moment, which I can tell you is not fun. So we have to ruin my smile and my happiness to negate all that. So yeah, so that's why social media is going down a little bit, but I'm cool. So thank you for your concern, but I'm alright.
So just to be clear, he's live on Instagram. Somebody says something to him. He pops in their DMs for a DM, a message, a voice note, sometimes calling these young girls. One user says this, bro is talking to a 17-year-old like they're his therapist. On another occasion, he pops in to talk to another young teen about going geocaching, which we'll talk about another situation to do with that in just a second, but this is weird.
Number one, it's a very important question. What is your favorite color balloon? I know, deep. And what are your thoughts on like walking, exploring, adventuring, the great outdoors?
In one situation, he was catfished by individuals that were pretending to be a 19-year-old girl that wanted to meet up and go geocaching, which is traveling and exploring.
Oi, why do you talk to 16-year-old girls?
What?
Why do you talk to 16-year-old
girls? Who's 16?
Huh?
Who's 16? Why are you filming this? Should we go talk to the police? Should we go
no.
to the police?
No.
Let's, should we do this? Have a chat with the police? Why are you trying to video?
Oh, just go,
this?
Hey.
More than! Talk to me,
Ed! He was asked about this situation and explains in detail how he goes about contacting young girls on his Instagram lives. Check this out.
But that brings me on to the point of when you met up with one of these to go geocaching, was it? Geocaching?
Geocaching.
And they threw a Billy Bear how at your face.
As long as you give me the 2 seconds to speak about that.
Yeah.
So, question. All right, she was 19. Paul, why are you going geocaching with a 19? Well, because it's geocaching. It's a walk in the countryside, finding something, move on to the next thing. It's not uber exciting. But if the person pops into Instagram live chats for months, integrating herself with people who are on a live chat, talking about families and doing that, in the live chat saying, oh, let's meet up for a geocache, I've sent you a message, and then I read the message, you go, okay. Let's go and do this geocaching, and then, yeah, meet me.
So this is not okay, and I'm going to tell you why. This man is sourcing his viewer base and using his online fame to basically using his social media as a Tinder profile to talk to young, vulnerable girls. And it is a pattern that he does this. Over 20 years in age difference, keep in mind, but it gets worse. One TikToker by the name of Boo, I believe it is, somebody that's had an ongoing controversy with Paul. Well, a 15-year-old reached out to her. This is what she said.
I said I was taking a break last night and I was going to, and then I got this message and it knocked me fucking sick. Essentially, a minor has contacted me to let me know that Paul was messaging them because they were sick. And this is the second time we have seen him do something similar. Allegedly, he was also messaging a girl who had cancer and liking their photos. Obviously, I have made the screenshots so you cannot tell who they are because they are a minor. Pause to read.
So this is what was said. Hi, boo, I've seen your TikToks on Paul, and I just want to say Paul messaged me in around March of this year. I am 15 years old. I was 15 at the time he messaged me, too. I have proof of the messages, if you'd like to see them. I don't know. I thought maybe texting you and giving you some more information like this, you could add to any TikToks you've been making about Paul in the future. Paul messaged me in regards to my first pinned post on my Instagram involving my ovarian disease, acting as though he was a safe place for me to reside. I think it's fairly obvious I'm underage. In the post, which he had clearly read, I state I've missed out on school, so I think that definitely gives Paul more proof of me being a teenager. I hope you have a good day. You're amazing.
I then went and did a bit of due diligence before responding to the messages to make sure I wasn't being had and the post is legit. You can tell she's a child in the post because she mentions school. Pause to read.
So as you can see here, Paul says, "Hi, I really hope you are okay. I read your health update post, and I'm sorry for all that you've been going through, it seems, for a while. Please, only surround yourself with those that genuinely care about you, and leave those that talk about you far, far away, I'm guessing." She says, "I'm okay. I blocked him after the first message I got. I just don't want any other girls my age to fall for his texts he is sending. I think it's so vile." And I absolutely do agree with that.
Obviously, this kid's got a good head on her shoulders because she blocked him straight away and knew not to respond. She also then went and checked her archive on her story and had posted photos of herself in her school uniform that day that Paul had viewed, so he knew she was a child. How anyone can keep excusing this bloke is beyond me. Paul, if you're watching, even if it's a nice message, it is not okay to message minors on Instagram. Stop it.
So we've already established a pattern of him going after young and vulnerable teens, which is creepy. One of his ex-moderators made a statement saying this. Now you can pause to read this. I'm going to zero in on, "Paul would always have a comeback for a reason as to why he was speaking to young girls. Then he met up with a 19-year-old. When challenged, he said her dad dropped her off. He was challenged again as this girl was confiding in him due to her mental health. We all then fell out as he hates being challenged and will run for the hills when any confrontation happens. He would then start speaking to girls but wouldn't tell us their ages until we probed and probed. Next live would happen and boom, he's doing exactly what we advised him not to do or say. Flirt with young girls, ask them to message him, ask if they had a boyfriend or not, etc., etc. We were just advising him not to talk to young girls."
And would you go for someone older than you?
No, never have.
Why?
Because I didn't realise I had to when I got TikTok. I just don't fancy older ladies.
Makes sense.
It turns out that Paul's been behaving this way for a very long time. Somebody discovered on his old social media about 18 years ago some very disturbing things. To an 18-year-old girl, he says, wow, I think that says it all. A 20-year-old, well, what can you say about her? Hubba hubba for one thing, wow. What a girl, just look at them eyes. Have you ever seen, wow, that's cringy. A 17-year-old, hey honey, you're gorgeous and so nice you're chatting to me, yay. Even a 16-year-old, wow, this girl is so yummy. She has the most amazing eyes. He just described a 16-year-old as yummy. It was discovered also by internet sleuths that the mother of Paul's child, well, he got her pregnant when she was just 16 years old. And if it was just 16 when she got pregnant, how long were they together before that? That's a very good question. One Twitter user posted a screenshot of a conversation with Paul where somebody says, "What about the very real evidence that you got a 16 to 17-year-old girl pregnant? I know you'll just block me and not answer the question anyways." He says, "Evidence," laughing face emoji, "we were in love and bought a house together and spent years together. But you know, never mind, FFS, what planet are you all on? Goodbye." Some other concerned citizens found Paul's Facebook and tracked down the dates from when he would have been with this girl, and she looks extremely young. "Just found these from a while back when I first found Snapshot Eye on my TikTok, and I had a little stalk on his Facebook. Enjoy." Now, this girl honestly looks about 14. In this one, they found out that her birthday was in November 1990. These photos are from April 2008. She would have been about 17 and 4 months here, with a visible bump. I don't know how long they were together prior to her pregnancy. Now, Paul was confronted about this on several occasions. He never denies it. He never says it's not true, but he acts extremely bizarre and uncomfortable. Check this out.
Can I just get this out there? Because it drives me up the wall. Who was 16 years old? Who?
So you can see he's very visibly in distress, avoiding the question. You can also see, and this is another thing that's true of him, when he gets pressured or stressed, he gets this red line in the middle of his face. It's very strange.
Oh, you said that for a smile. Boom! Oh, my days. I'm so sorry. Not to you guys, because you guys should probably understand by now. Stop believing every single caption you see on the internet, man. You have to, guys. I do like smiles. You have to. You've got to stop believing every single caption you read on the internet. If I say in a minute on a video I'm pregnant with twin puppies, are you going to go, I can't believe Paul's pregnant with twin puppies?
I wanted to pause this and explain to you what we're seeing here. This is Paul in an Instagram live stream. And this is somebody sending him a DM. Just like I said before, that when he's in these live streams, he's sourcing these young girls through Instagram DMs while he's live streaming. This is evidence that he does do this. I believe very strongly that this man is an alleged groomer skirting on the edge of legality, similar to YouTuber Anision. This just keeps getting stranger. Just for reference, the age of consent in the UK says it's 16 years old. Moreover, the UK's territories all have their own local age of consent laws. However, at present, all of these territories also set the age of consent as 16. Now, another thing to point out is that even though the age of consent is 16, it's pretty much unanimous that if anybody is, an older man going after this young a girl, it's considered creepy. It's considered creepy in the United States. We have a couple states here that also have the age of consent of 16, but we do have Romeo and Juliet laws where you can't be that much older. I don't know if the UK has that, but it's also important to point out that under 18 in the UK is considered a child. In England, a child is defined as anyone who has not reached their 18th birthday. Child Protection Guidance points out that even if the child has reached 16 years of age and is living independently. Here's some of the evidence that I found and gathered where he talks to them in just ways that one should not talk to their fan base.
When's your lunch break? Not you. When's your lunch break? Am I single? No. Actually, yeah, I'm not. I'm taken. Is it easy if I say that? Will I? Well, we need to get practicing, don't we? When are we starting practicing? Yeah, I know, I saw that. When are we starting practicing? When's this happening? When's this happening? Jess, hi. It's when you want me to be. Everything's down to you. For you, I am always free, so you need to let me know. I'm always free, so my schedule is, I can do what I want with my schedule. So you need to, everything's for you. Harsh, but fair. I am dominant, but you're in charge of this one. No. Free reign for you. So you have to make up your mind. And put in ball in your court.
God almighty, in heaven's name. In this next one, he's asking a young girl to send him a picture of her smiling in her towel.
Right, basically, I just wanted to see you smile. Then there was a towel involved, and that towel was going to smile. And then you going to be in the towel smiling. I just wanted to see you smile. That's all I wanted to see. This one. So, where's my smile? Hi. And yes, I'll see you in the towel. And a smile. Just a smile.
He's also called out about doing this thing about feet and wanting to see their feet. Like, how in the...
Paul's response to being called out for asking for feet pics.
Anything, you're with your pet, you're at your happiest moment,
you try and get some confidence in putting your photo out there and going, hi, this is me. Bit of fan interaction, follower interaction, as you will, friend interaction. So when I did that game and said, show me a picture of your feet, whether they're wearing slippers, socks, hobble, naked feet, send it to me, or with a funny face, or do this with all of your hand. People then take that as being very sexual and grooming and anything else, because that seems to be what is in their mind all of the time. I'm so sorry that's how you think, and that anything that somebody does or fun is for sexual reasons. I can't help that that's the way your brain works.
Paul, you're over 20 years. Over 20 years, they're senior. These are little girls. Here's a clip of him actually trying to meet up with some young girls.
I'm good, Zoe. How are you? How are you? Zoe, Natasha, I want a random question, please. If you travel somewhere. Good night, Amy. I'll be round. You and your family. Sunday lunch tomorrow. I'll catch the train down to Overbrook. Sussex. Sussex? Is it Sussex?
Again, these girls are about 20 years old, 19 years old. It is legal, but given the context of how the other creepy stuff in the video, I believe I should have added this as well, because it's, I mean, it tracks. Obviously, people are not stupid and have been confronting Paul, and he has been doxing them, contacting their places of work. This man is genuinely unhinged. Check this out.
Think you can do all this bullshit without any recompense. Well, make sure everything's private, people. Make sure everything is private. You post comments on my stuff. Make sure you're fully, fully private. Because I'll also find a way. Unbelievable. Oh, and sir, thank you for letting me see your registration number. Thank you. That was very nice of you. Yeah, if I punched you, I need your advice. So this second account, I don't know what to do, whether it's going to be a dancing account or whether we'll use this account as an investigation account, like an official investigation account with like evidence or just people's names and who they are in society and what they bring to society and their views on other people. And I don't know whether to do that, because I've heard those investigation TikToks are like really informative, really officially truthful and stuff. So should we start with my newfound friends from the internet?
I'm now going to show you a couple of screenshots where he does indeed dox some people. And it's in an email to somebody's work. He says, to whom it may concern, I'm writing this email in a state of shock and disgust at one of your employees interactions against me on social media. The lady represents you and is happy to post your company on her Facebook page, whilst also spreading malicious rumors about me on there and other social media platforms. I find this behavior totally abhorrent and slanderous. The attached screenshot is just one of many things she has posted about me. Yours sincerely, Paul Breach. Here's one where he posts a user, says, quick shout out to Camilla. Turns out your job and education isn't the only thing that you have a passion for. Bad mouthing me also seems fun for you. Another one, he says, so Billy, you send me obnoxious messages that I can use as evidence, and I mean actual evidence, not just pathetic hearsay that you tried to say to me. You also seem to have now taken down what you do for work on your profile. Surely stand by what you say, and you have nothing to hide. So if your workplace hears what you say to a random stranger, I'm sure they would be very happy with you. The individual from the last screenshot reached out to somebody, and this is what he had to say about this situation. Can you pop this over to the Tattle page for me? I'm over it now. I called him out based on evidence I've seen and believed to be true. And I must have struck a nerve with some home truce. If he breaks the guidelines and things directed to me, please report his page. He's already shared my Instagram, which I'm getting message after message on. I'm going to be adult about this and leave it at that. So we've established that Paul cannot take criticism and is willing to stoop to criminal behavior. Recently, Paul was spotted in an alleyway. This is very recent, an alleyway with a teenage girl that he likely sourced from using his online fame. This is the same young girl that he's posted pictures of on his Instagram. Interestingly enough, he has deleted the pictures of the female that he had on his Instagram account. This happens after his TikTok has been banned. I don't know if his TikTok will be permanently banned, but I do know that he's made an additional account. When Paul was asked about this, his response was that he is not ashamed and alluded that he took explicit photos of the teen.
I'm not ashamed of taking those photos. They were really nice photos. The only photos I took outside.
This is the OnlyFans creator. As you can see, she looks about 12 years old. I'm going to be completely honest with you. But she is, in fact, of age. I believe she's 20, or no, she's 19. One user saying a 19-year-old making OF content while staying with Paul Breach. The young girl came out with a statement talking about her experience, saying she was afraid of Paul.
What kind of photos did he take for you? Did anything make you feel uncomfortable?
I'll answer one uncomfortable comment tonight, and that'll be this one. But basically, so the first day, it was nothing like that. It was just the normal picture. That was the first day. And then the second day, we did the one where I'm facing the wall. And then on the night, yeah, there was a plan to do not the sort of dirty content that you're, like, a lot of people are thinking. It's like, it was more like underwear.
Yeah, kind of like a lingerie shoot.
I feel like, for me, it just didn't, like, red flag. I just thought, like, I thought it was normal, like, I guess. Because I thought this is my job, so it just feels normal, and it doesn't really feel taboo to me. It would have felt taboo if it was, like, but yeah. I think there was a problem with it. So it's why, because I don't want to say anything bad about him, because I'm just scared, I think.
Shortly after this, Paul was caught out in public in a crowd and called the police to escort him home because he feared for his life. Paul then locked all of his social media down and released a statement. Now, there's a lot more to this story, a lot more of evidence, a lot more of things I could have talked about, but literally, there's so much out there that I could make hours and hours and hours of content on this, and my general purpose was to get this out there for you guys so you can share it with anybody that needs to see it, to let you know that this person is probably not somebody that you want your kids talking to on Instagram Live. Stay diligent, and as interesting as this is, or since it's more interesting to me, that's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think, so why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below. Thumbs up for those likes, as always, brothers and sisters. I will see you in the next video. That's nasty, but thank you to my patrons for your continued and ongoing support. We're at 67 patrons with a goal of 70. If you want to help me get to that goal, link is in the description. It'll be also in the pinned comment. Check it out. See if it's something for you. If you want to support what we do here on this channel and get your name at the end of my videos like these guys, go ahead and do that. Also, again, I want to thank everybody that's donated on the new charity. We're currently, we've raised 100 of 1,000 to help children in ABUSC situations, to prevent those types of situations. So if you have donated on this, help us meet that goal. Let me know in the comment section below. And I really appreciate you guys. And that's just another way to show that you're repping. If you're not repping, you're Greg. And how you do that, all you do is subscribe with notifications turned on. Be in the comment section after every single video, because I'm going to be there. Greg the Cat's going to be there in spirit, and the rest of the Red Sox community as well. And I expect to see you there, because this channel loves you.